Psalms chapter 68, and I will read for today from verses 1 up to verse 3. And this is what my Bible says: Let God arise, let his enemies be scattered, and let those also who hate him flee before him. As smoke is driven away, so drive them away. As wax melts before the fire, so let the wicked perish at the presence of God. But let the righteous be glad. Let them rejoice before God. Yes, let them rejoice exceedingly. Father, we thank you for your word today. Thank you, Father, for giving us this word to talk about this wonderful evening. Father, I pray that you're going to give your power over this word, that it is going to touch somebody's life, change their lives, and transform their lives. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. After reading this wonderful word of God today, the Lord gave me a message that we are going to talk about today. And the title of my message today is, Let God Arise. That is the message that God gave me today to share with each and every person that is watching us today. That let God arise. I don't know what you are going through. I don't know what you need God for. But I want to believe that as you are watching me today, there is something that you need God for today. There is something that as you are watching right now, you are praying and there is a burden in your heart and you're saying, I'm going through this situation today. This is happening in my life and I really need to see God come through. I really need to see God come and make things right for me and in my life. And as you're watching today, maybe there is something that you're trusting God for and you've been praying about it to see it coming through, to see it happening, to see it working out for you. But the more you pray, things are not been happening. So you really need God as you're watching today. You really need to see God today. But I want to encourage you that before the end of this show, God is going to arise in the midst of that thing that you need him to see him today. The Bible says that when God arises, there's things that happens. The enemies are being scattered. And today I want to assure you that when God arises in your life today, everything, every pain that you have been going through, it is going to be put to an end in the mighty name of Jesus. I don't know what kind of pain that you have been going through, but when God arises today, the pain that you have been going through, the pain that has been making you to cry, the pain that has been making you to making people to look down on you, and this is going to be the end of it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every endless toil is going to be to stop today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I know maybe some of you've been through so many disappointments in life. You've been trying so many things to work things out, but the more you try, you've been experiencing a lot of disappointments because the people you've been calling friends disappointed you. They turned their back to you, and when you expected them to even support you or to just pick well for you, the only good thing they could do is to speak bad about you, to destroy you, to tarnish your name, and then you just felt so disappointed. I want to assure you today that this is the right time, this is the right day that God is arising for you. God is arising for your sake, and all the disappointments are going to come to stop in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. But I want to also let you know that as God is going to arise in that situation, as God is going to arise in your life today to come and amend the broken things, to come and repair every broken thing in your life, there is also something that you as a person must also do today, just to allow God to arise. There is something. He's not just going to arise when you're going to be sitting down just sleeping and doing nothing, but he's going to arise for somebody that is today is going to be doing something instead of just being there sitting down and just letting things happen. You know, people are just sitting down and you see things happening in your life. They're just happening. Bad things just happen to you and you're just watching and you're just there, not even praying, not doing nothing. When you're going to be such kind of a person, I want to tell you that maybe that is not going to allow God to arise in that situation today. But if you want to God to arise in the situation that you are going through today, everything that you need him, whatever you need to see him today, if you want to see him today, then I want to encourage you and to tell you that you must aggressively lay hold of the great future God has planned for you. You know, when God created you as a person, he programmed you and he wired you perfectly with a purpose. There is things that God has, whenever he was creating you and wiring you and programming you, he created you and wired your blessings also inside you. He also wired your miracles inside you. He also wired you with your callings inside you. And today, if you are going to realize that you are such a special person, that you were created for a purpose, you are created with a reason, and then you go to realize today that there are greater plans, good plans in the future for you. There are at the destiny, at the end, as you soldier on this journey of salvation, there are greater plans that God has for you. The moment you realize this, then I want to encourage you today that you also need to endure every pain that you are going through. You have to endure them. You have to remain steadfast. You have to remain strong and stay focused and look upon the cross, look upon God, and know that it is only with him that he is going to arise in that situation. Just depend upon him, trust him fully today, and just know that he's going to come in and he's going to help you overcome the enemies. He's going to help you overcome every pain in your life, every struggle in your life, every disappointment in your life. Today, if you are going to show that you are going to stand firm, you are going to stand strong and to endure every pain and to stay focused, I want to assure you that God is going to arise in that situation. And somebody is asking me right now that how am I going to know when God arises in my situation? I have been through this painful life. I've been struggling a lot, and somebody is asking me, I don't know how I am going to realize that God has actually arises in for me in this situation. When God arises, there are two things that will happen in your life, and these two things are going to make you know that God is for you and by you, and he has got hold of your hands and not letting go of you. He's walking through with you through the challenges. Number one, when God arises in your life, when he arises in that situation, all your enemies are going to be scattered today in the name of Jesus Christ. Wherever they are gathered and talking about you, planning for your downfall, when God is going to arise today, all of them are going to be scattered. They are going to be destroyed into pieces. They are not going to be there anymore. When God arises again, his people, who is you that is watching me today, his people is going to gather unto him for rest. If you, God is going to arise today, everything that you have been struggling to do, today God is going to give you a rest. You know, we are in a field of a battlefield. We are fighting with our enemies, but today God is coming in and is arising in between us and the enemy, and he's taking charge to scatter the enemies so that you can get rest in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So maybe you're watching and you say, I've been trying for many times, and the more I try, so I feel today I am so tired and I'm so down. I don't know how I'm going to make it again. But I want to tell you, after God has taken over and your enemies are scattered, then you are also going to get rest in the mighty name of Jesus today. The Bible says in the book of James, chapter 12, verse 3b, Almighty God says, he will bless those who bless you and curse him who curses or uses insolent language towards you. Every person that curses you as a child of God today, that is your enemy. And I want to tell you that if you did not know, your enemy is God's enemy. Whoever hates you as a child of God is also an enemy of God. So today God is just saying that whoever curses you as a child of God, he will also curse him, and he will also bless the person that blesses you. And this is just a powerful encouragement to you as a child of God, as you're watching today, and also to you who does not believe in Christ, as you are going to accept Jesus today, that when you become a child of God, he is going to arise for you, he is going to fight for you, and after fighting for you, he is going to protect you, and after protecting you, he is going to make sure that every tongue that will be cursing you will be cursed, and every tongue that is going to bless you will be blessed. Your enemies will be God's enemies in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Lord tells us in the book of Jeremiah chapter 33 verse 3 that call to me and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things which you do not know. If you call unto the name of Jesus today, if you call unto him in that situation that you want to see him, in that trouble that you want to see him, if you are going to stand strong and cry out loudly and say, Jesus, I want to see you in this situation today. The Bible says that when you call him today as you are watching me, he is going to answer your prayer. He is going to answer that call. And when he answers that call, he is going to show you greater and mighty things which you do not know, the things you've never expected that can happen in your life, the things you've never expected that can be part of your life. Today, if you are going to call upon the name of the Lord and say that I am tired of this situation, I am tired of this life, Lord, I want you to arise up, I want you to be part of it and at the center of it and take charge and take control, then God is going to arise in that situation and you are going to be a winner in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. When you allow God to arise in your life, he will bring you a new season of favor, increase and overflow. He will also scatter the enemies that have come against you. Every power of the enemies, every plan of the enemies that have been coming against you, every plan that have ever planned against you today, God is going to scatter them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And as he's going to arise in that situation, your life is not going to remain the same again, because the old season is going and God is bringing a new season in your life. His favor is going to change your life today. Everything that you ever need in him, today God is going to cause an increase and overflow in your life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And so as you're watching, I want to assure you that when God arises, things are going a new twist is going to be experienced in your life today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. But you also need to rise up today as you're watching today, as God is arising and taking charge, taking control and bringing a new season and giving a new face. You also need to rise up today and just worship the Lord and declare that he is your healer. And today, if you're sick, just declare that Jesus, as you are arising in my situation, you are my healer, so that you can receive your healing. And just declare that he is the restorer, so that you can get everything that you ever lost to the enemies, everything that you've ever lost to the hands of Satan. Today, if you're just going to stand strong and worship God and just declare that he is your restorer, he's going to be brought back to you in the name of Jesus Christ. Maybe you are living in lack. Just stand up and worship the Lord and just declare that, God, you are my provider, you are my peace if you need peace, and God is just going to do it to you in the name of Jesus Christ. Just change the way you do things, and I want to assure you, as you are going to change the way you're doing things, just rise up also to worship the Lord and just declare new things in your life. I've been telling people that there is power in the I am that we keep on telling people, there is power behind it. And today, if you're just going to stand up and change it, and things are going to change in your life also, you're going to experience a supernatural God's peace, a supernatural God's provision, a supernatural God restoring everything. Everything is just going to be supernatural in your life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I want to assure you today that God wants you to experience a great change today as you are going to rise up and worship him. He will give you a beauty to your ashes, a joy for your pain, a victorious praise for your sadness, and a dancing for your mourning. Today that is going to happen in your life for that person that is just going to stand up and worship the Lord and start declaring that God is the super power person in their lives in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. He's rising thing in your life, that situation, and every oppressor in your life is going to bow and be scattered in the mighty name of Jesus. And in the book of Psalms chapter 68 verse 3, the Bible also says that when he arises for his people, when he arises for his people, the righteous will be glad and they will rejoice before God. They are also going to be happy and joyful. The righteous, as you are watching me today, when he arises in your life, you are going to be so full of joy today, and you are going to rejoice in him in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. When God arises, the righteous will be glad and rejoice. We will be happy and joyful. In the past, if you are sad and in tears, today is the day of the Lord, the day of joy. God is going to wipe away your tears, every tear, and every tear, and restore joy in us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The joy that you've been looking for, the joy that the peace that you've been looking for, that you've been in need for a long time, when God arrives today, he's going to wipe that tear, the tear that he has been shedding and rolling down your cheeks for a long time. God is going to wipe it out today, and he's going to give you joy in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You also need to move with God. When God moves, you also need to move with him. When Moses was with the children of Israel in the wilderness, and they were in a journey headed to the promised land, when we read our Bible, the Bible says that they were walking and following and moving with God. Every time the Bible says they were moving with the cloud. When the cloud moved, they will follow and move with him. That cloud represented God. So they were moving with God every time. And the Bible says, when you read the book of Numbers chapter 35, that every time Moses will shout and say, "Rise up, Lord, and let your enemies be scattered, and let those who hate you flee before you." And so after the enemies who hate God has flown away, and then God is leading, and then you just move with him. If you are going to start moving with God, then things are going to take new direction in your life today in the name of Jesus Christ. Things are going to change in your life, and God is going to arise and just take charge. He's going to be leading you in every step that you make in your life. But if you're going to be moving on your own way, then God is going to let you do it, because you have a free choice of choosing what to do with your life. But today you have to choose to move with God, for God to arise in that situation that you need him to see him in your life today. So I urge every person that is watching me and is in need is saying that I really need God. I really need God to arise today in my life and in this situation. I want to encourage you that you need to start moving with God. You start to start following the footsteps of God. Start following the directions of God. Start listening to his voice and just follow his voice in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And when God arises, changes will happen. Whenever he arises, changes will happen. To the children of Israel, the cry of "Let God arise" became a cry of change. And today, as you are watching me, the cry that you're going to make today in worship, that God please arise in my situation, that cry is going to be the beginning of changes in your life. It is going to be the starting point of miracles in your life in the name of Jesus Christ. It was a cry of forward. And indeed, God was moving with them from one camp to another camp, and allowing them to learn and get experience from all the stages that you are going through. And that is what God is going to do with you today. You are not going to be where you have been for all this long time, but God is going to listen to you cry to him, and he's going to move with you. He's going to travel with you into the unknown land, into the new places that are excited, that are so good, that are so pleasing before him, and that is going to make you so full of joy, and that is going to make you so, laugh and be excited in the name of Jesus Christ. As they they were getting closer to the promised land, their stability came from the Lord who was with them in the previous camp, and they remembered him. We do not know what tomorrow holds for every one of us, but we know one thing, that the Lord who led us in the yesterday is the same God who is going to lead us today and tomorrow and forevermore. As you are watching today, just don't forget that the same God that was with you yesterday, the same God that made you to get a meal on your table yesterday, it is the same God today and tomorrow, and he is the same God that is going to be there forever. If you are going to allow him to come and arise in your situation, then things will continue happening for your favor. Things will continue happening for in your life and changing in the name of Jesus Christ. Yeah. So I urge every person that is watching me today, and that person that is ready to cry out loud today to Jesus and ask him to arise in his situation, I encourage you to just get ready for God's good changes now, because they are just coming in your life, and you're just going to be surprised just to experience and also to watch new things just coming in your life today. I want to assure you that your financial struggles are going to change in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. God is going to give you victory over the unanswered prayers over your life today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Marriages are going to be are going to happen in the name of Jesus Christ. Maybe you're watching me and the only thing that you're coming before God with is I need a good marriage. Jesus, today I want to assure you that God is arising today, marriages are going to be experienced and you are going to receive yours in the mighty name of Jesus. Every broken marriage is going to be fixed and restored in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And many of you are going to get even new jobs today, as you are going to declare that God arise in my situation. New jobs are going to come in your way, and you are going to be blessed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Even the church of the Lord is going to grow today, as we are going to cry out to the Lord. And you are a pastor, and you need the only thing that you need God for today is you need to see him arise in your church. I want to tell you that he is going to arise in that church, and that church that has been stagnant, has not growing, today in the name of Jesus Christ, it is going to grow in the name of Jesus Christ, and God is going to bring new souls to fill that church to the brim, and you will be celebrating Jesus Christ. And as you are watching me right now, I want to assure you that things are going to start changing as you are going to worship the Lord and cry out unto him and say, Lord, arise in my situation. Definitely is going to arise, and there will be calmness, there is going to be safeness in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And I say, as I finish, that let God arise every day in our life. Let God arise every week in our life, every month in our life. Let God arise in every year of your life. Let God arise and let you experience the greatness and the goodness of our Almighty God in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. God bless you so much for watching with us at this live broadcast today, and thank you so much for sharing this live broadcast with your friends and inviting them. I want to assure you that their lives and your life will not be the same again. Our brother Joseph Gift Ndama has just requested that we pray for his family. They have lost a loved one and they need us to pray for them. And also we have Pastor Alfred Roy, who is saying that we need to pray for his ministry in Bangladesh. And today we are just going to pray for our these wonderful brothers that have sent their prayer request. And if you're there, you also want to send yours, just make sure you send it. Somebody will pray with you. You can also send a text message or a WhatsApp message to that number there now, or even anytime, and someone will pray with you, or to that email address, and will pray for you. Father, we thank you for these wonderful brothers. I thank you for our brother Jose Joseph Gift Ndama, my father, that he has requested that we pray for his family, as right now they have lost their loved one and they're grieving and they're in pain, my father, after losing their loved one. Father, as they are experiencing this tough, hard time and painful time, Lord, I ask you to arise in this situation. I ask you to arise in this situation, arise in this painful moment, Father, and give them peace, my Father. Give them joy, my Father. Encourage them, my Father. Give them strength in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Wipe their tears and give them joy. And in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Lord, I thank you for Pastor Alfred Roy, who is having a ministry in Bangladesh. Today, he has watched the live broadcast, my Father, and he has asked that we share a prayer over his ministry. Lord, I want to believe that he be also know that when you arise for his ministry, then his ministry is going to have life again. When you arise for his ministry, then the enemies that are against this ministry are going to be scattered. Today, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray for the ministry of Pastor Alfred Roy. Father, that you may be part of this ministry, be at the center of this ministry, make this ministry your ministry, my Father. Let people experience your power and miracle through this ministry. Let people see your love through this ministry. Let this ministry be a blessing to the people of Bangladesh in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let new souls be won through this ministry. Let the poor, the orphans and widows get blessed through this ministry. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray and bless the Lord. Amen.